In this episode, Richard Burns Rally Review, Xlerator Wheelstand Review, and Top Sim Cars.
Episode 55 is sponsored by Sim Raceway.
Welcome to another episode of Inside Sim Racing. We're going to be getting down and dirty today with Richard Burns Rally.
Love driving in the dirt.
One of the show's favorites. And I'm your host, Jessica Lopez.
Darren Gangi here.
Thank you guys for joining us. We're also going to be showing you the Xlerator wheel stand today.
Yep, and we have the big boy and the regular stand, and we've tested it with the G27 and the 360.
All right, well, let's see what they thought.
All right, next up, we're going to be talking about the Xlerator wheel stand. We had them on the last show and mentioned we'd have them on this show.
Yeah, a little teaser in the last one.
This works with Logitech and the Xbox 360 wheels. And actually, I just was at his site, and he's got an older version that works with an older Fanatic wheel, the Joytech Nitro, Mad Cats. So if you got an older wheel like that, you might want to check with him. Go to the site.
And that's the nice thing also. I mean, you mentioned the Xbox. It does take the adapter, though. So if you're going to use the Xbox 360 wheel, it's a $20 adapter to get it on. But
let's talk pricing.
Okay.
Speaking of which.
Hit them up.
Without adapters, just for the standard Logitech wheel, $99. And then for a big boy, no adapters, $109.
And then we've got, like I mentioned, the Xbox 360 adapter at $20. And then the G27 adapter is actually $30 because you're also going to need the shifter mount as well, which is included in that.
And the plate's bigger for the pedals. It's drilled out for both the Logitech and the Xbox 360 pedals, but you actually have to do like a wood screw into the bottom of the pedals.
Which is interesting.
Of the Xbox pedals, not the G25 pedals.
So it might play with your warranty a little since you're drilling through the plastic, but
I don't know
how many people are setting them in.
Definitely might affect your warranty. So let's see. It's a little small for the Fanatic wheel, for the current Fanatic wheel.
Yeah, it has a lot of distance that it needs for those clamps. Same thing with the Thrustmaster. I think you'd run into the same problem. There's very shallow deck to latch onto. Works great with the Logitech wheels.
Yep, and with the adapter for the Xbox 360 wheel, it works really great.
Yeah, definitely.
So let's talk about the pros and cons.
Okay.
So first up, one of the great pros is it's a great console couch rig.
Yeah, this is just... you're quick and easy, grab it out of the closet, sit down on the couch and play. One of the things we both loved about it was the ability to put the stand up and get in and out of the couch.
Show some footage of you. Yeah, we'll show you guys this right now. Yeah, this was the easiest rig to get up from the couch with. Like Sean said, you just push it up, things stand straight up, and you're off going to get a drink or whatever you want to do.
Yeah, and then when you're talking about that, I mean, I've always referred to any sim rig as a girlfriend killer. So being able to actually throw it in the closet really quick is a big plus.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. Cost, it's very affordable for the starting sim racer.
Way you can just sit down really quickly, I think, is its best asset. The other thing is, again, like you mentioned, the couch. If you had a lazy boy kind of chair, it's actually really interesting the way the support stays down there, but it actually gives you a really good footing. I mean,
we did not expect this thing to be stable at all.
No.
We honestly scoffed at it when we saw it at E3, like we mentioned, but... you know what? Looks can be deceiving. This thing is actually a stable platform.
Yeah. I think another thing that we loved about it was how quick and easy it came out of the box.
Yep.
I think it took us longer to take the wrapping off of it than it did to actually put it together.
Speaking of which, we got a little assembly video.
Of course.
Let's play that real quick.
As you can see, it goes together very easily. Again, the unwrapping and getting it out of the box and finding the instructions, read the instructions, that took a little bit longer.
Yep.
But there are a few things that didn't go real well in the process.
Yep, here's the cons.
Yeah, and I'm a small guy. There was two models, as you noticed in the beginning, the regular and the big boy. I needed the big boy. It needed to be lifted a little higher on my lap.
The standard is probably good for a child, honestly. It's someone very small who, whose feet can hit the ground. That's another thing. I mean, if the couch is too high, you're going to have a lower setup, but then, their feet can hit it. The other con is it's only good on a couch. You can't do it on a standard desk chair or anything like that because you need a little, you need almost some wings off the sides.
Feet need to rest.
Yeah, they need to go on something because you don't want it resting on your lap. Otherwise, you just might as well make it a lap wheel.
Also on the adjustability between the big boy and the regular stand, also there wasn't, even though it is adjustable, it didn't really put the pedals far out or close in or the wheel. There were adjustments, but not a lot of adjustability.
Yep.
Now, you're looking at 6.5 and 5.5. It did work for both of us, though.
Yep, we were able to, and mainly with the big boy, especially for me. The other one was kind of, I was cramped.
Yeah.
A little claustrophobic, I guess you could say, with that one. But the big boy worked great for me, and especially for a starter rig, it's definitely works. And that leads us to our score, and the way we're going to score, we're not going to do the thumbs up, thumbs down crap
that's
anymore.
Out.
Yeah, that's out. We got a new little hardware scale. It's just going to be a 10 possible points. And for a product like this, we're going to figure in compatibility, cost, stability, construction, ergonomics, adjustability, and portability. So out of a 10 possible,
gave it a 7.
Gave it a 7.
And basically, what we have is a really fine stand here.
Yep.
I would have liked to have seen a little more adjustability.
1 point off for that.
It was a little wiggly, even though we joked about it being wiggly. It was more stable than I thought it would be, but it still was not the most stable rig in the
world.
Probably
depends on how stable your couch is. If you got a really cushiony couch, that thing's going to be moving a little bit. You got a firmer couch, it might stick a little bit.
A little more anti-roll bar stiffing it up, maybe.
And then one for the compatibility. When we say compatibility, not compatible with other chairs.
Right.
Lots of compatibility with wheels, the Logitech and that Xbox wheel.
And on your freestanding wheel and pedal holder, you expect to be able to use it on just about any kind of chair or couch. So it's a little short in that department as well.
So that's going to do it. Xlerator wheel stand, bunch of different options from the standard big boy, different attachments. XWstands.com, you can get them. Also, shipping is additional. When I checked it to my location, it was about $11. That's in the U.S. Not sure about international. He's shipping through Amazon.com, so you can just have to check through his site and check in your local region if it's available. That's going to do it. Hope you enjoyed our review of it.
Next up, we head on over to our top simulation cars of all time. And since we're going to have Richard Burns rally on the show a little later today, we decided to take a car from there and put it onto the list.
Yep. Actually talked to my good friend Abby over at Rally Sim, who they're the creators of the RSRBR 2010 mod, and asked what her favorite car was, and she said the Peugeot 205. So I actually got to figure out which 205 she was talking about because there's quite a few of them, but that's going to be one of our cars.
And from SimRaceway.com, we're taking the top fanned car, the F1 2007 F1 McLaren by MMG.
Yep.
And speaking of Sim Raceway, earlier this week I opened a profile or an account at the website.
You can do some racing?
I just might. I don't know. It depends on what
look
kind
out,
of
man.
Feedback
she's
I
fast,
get.
Guys. Jessie Marie Lowe is her, we'll put her account name right down there. But so you guys can check her out over at Sim Raceway. Maybe I think they can actually fan you. They can become a fan of you, I think. I don't know.
We'll find out.
We will find out.
All right, so on to our top simulation cars of all time, sponsored by SimRaceway.com.
So here we are for the 10th installment of Top Sim Cars.
Stacking them up, man.
Big time. The 22nd and 23rd cars added to the list. We got more and more people getting involved on the forum, giving scores and making suggestions, or even better, arguing with us about our bad suggestions or scores.
Yeah.
But the list does grow on, and today we're going to add two. The first one being the McLaren from the MMG 2001 Formula One mod. This is the MP4-22 I believe is the super technical edition of that car.
Yep, driven by Lewis Hamilton and Fernando Alonso that year. And then after that, we're going to have the Peugeot 205 Rally. And this car was recommended by a good friend of mine, Abby, who's over at RSRB, one of the creators of RSRBR 2010 and all the previous packs.
Yeah.
And along with her husband and a lot of other people. But asked her what her favorite car was, and she said the Peugeot 205 from the F2000 12-1 pack. There's so many packs in that mod. It's incredible.
And this is the brand new mod that they just recently released.
Yep. Well, that car may have been around for a while, but it's 2010 is the most current version. So let's just start with that car.
We've got the timer going, minute and a half.
Alrighty. So speaking of that car, the Peugeot, this particular model was produced between 1988 and 1992. And this is the rally version. There was a GTI version. And this thing's a little underpowered, I would say. Only 138 horsepower.
Well, we tried in a few different areas. We did that uphill hill climb
Pike's Peak.
The dirt. Yeah, Pike's Peak, gutless car. I mean,
that thing was struggling to get up that hill. I think we both ran about a 12-minute, 30-second Pike's Peak run.
But it would be the equivalent of taking the Megane to, like, Le Mans. Yeah. You know, it's like you got to pick the right place. And then when we got it on tarmac on a windy place,
it came alive.
It wasn't necessarily short on horsepower at that point.
Front wheel drive.
Yeah, definitely drives
1294 cc, 5-speed, two-wheel drive, 3 doors, and it's a cool, like Sean said, this thing's really not meant for dirt or snow, but you could drive it. You know, great starter car. This is great for somebody just getting into rally, you know, can't get into too much trouble with it.
Yeah, and we were doing a lot of rally racing with a lot of our friends back in the day, and the more you could pick a car like this, the better it suited itself for everybody involved. So all of a sudden, some of the slower drivers had a really good shot at beating the faster drivers because the car just sort of handicapped the field.
Talk about some of our scores really quick. 18.3 in physics. This car scored really well.
Yes, it did.
13.8 in sounds. 8 and 3 quarters. We're out of time there. That was in 8 and 3 quarters. That was in models.
So overall, how'd it do?
87.3, which tied it with the Lotus 79 from iRacing.
Fantastic.
So yeah, great score, great car.
Loved it.
One thing I want to say, probably would have scored a little bit higher, maybe in fun factor, if it had a little more power.
Sure.
A little under horsepowered for us, but had a blast with it. And we gave it a 9 in fun factor. So.
Absolutely.
Next up,
the McLaren. So here we go, back to Formula One. We go from a slow car to quite possibly one of the fastest cars on Earth.
Probably the fastest car we've put on this list so far.
Definitely.
You know, we're gonna try to put together a list. We've been saying this. Put together a list of lap times. We ran a 109 at Eastern Creek in this thing. You know, just the bone stock setup. Speaking of which, great default setup in this car.
Yeah, and that's the way when we talk about default setup, that's one of the things. We're taking all these cars to Eastern Creek, usually if it's an R-Factor car or a similar track, and using whatever set it came with to determine how well the overall balance is and how well it suited is for any novice driver, really.
We gave it a 4.25. You know, one thing I want to talk about, models.
Oh, my God.
What a beautiful model of this.
Yeah.
These guys did an incredible job of just... This thing's just perfection. It's a beautiful car.
Yeah, and if McLaren was looking for a promotional tool that was 2 years old, of course, since the new ones are out. But, I mean, it's that beautiful. It can be used in a commercial. It's camera-ready, so to speak. Incredible.
Another thing that makes this mod come alive, Real Feel. Make sure, go to R-Factor Central and check the Real Feel settings. There's a few there that we plugged in. And then, if it feels weird at center... Sean had it on negative. Anyway, make sure your slider and your force feedback settings either at the plus or negative. If it feels odd, put it the other way, and it should feel a lot
better. And
maybe
this is something we do in a tech tip later, but you know, Real Feel is really important. Or getting the settings that you like. I mean, this car required, at the speeds and the handling, but when we got the Real Feel right, when we got the force feedback right, everything right, it's amazing how great the car felt. I mean, just
sounds are great. We got the timers. I think the timer died.
I think we're coming up on a minute and a half right now.
Yeah, we're out of time. So, man, this another high-scoring car. This was the top fan car at Sim Raceway, which is one of the reasons why we picked it. You can one-click install it from there, speaking of which.
Yeah.
MMG guys did a great job. 89.3 overall, which puts it right behind the Dallara.
And again, incredible cockpits. I'm sorry, I'm going over time, but the cockpits were amazing. Everything sucked you into this car. It was really a pleasure to drive.
Yep. So that puts it right behind the Dallara, and which puts it third on our list. And then the Peugeot had a tie for fourth with the Lotus 79.
Wow, so up to the top of the list. Last time I think we were
those
a little
are both
lower.
Those are both in the top five. So two great cars added to the list. If you guys haven't checked them out, make sure you do. You know, you're going to see this our review of Rally Sim, and man, what an incredible mod. One of my favorite sims.
Yeah, and you can see the growing list at the website. Get on the forum, send in your suggestions. It helps us out.
Next up, I think we're going to do, I'm not going to even say. So check out our next one, number 11. We'll see you next time. Happy holidays, everybody.
We need to interrupt this program for a special report. 21-year-old Florian Denard wins a $5,000 sim rig in the GT3 Challenge at Sim Raceway. The annual Mod of the Year awards are back. Vote now on all five categories, including Cars, Tracks, Painter, Video, and Screenshot of the Year in R-Factor and GTR2. 15 handmade trophies will be given to the top three in each category. Watch here on Inside Sim Racing as we announce the winners live. Mod of the Year voting opens January 14th and closes February 11th. Voting is open to all members of Sim Raceway.
Moving on to Richard Burns Rally, touted as the best rally sim of all time.
I backed that up.
Came out back in 2004 and has been releasing mods pretty consistently since its release.
Oh, yeah, and especially, you know, with RSRBR, they've been doing tons of updates consistently throughout the last few years, and, you know, with their RSRBR 2010 mod this year, so lots going on with it. But time to put it on the weighted rating scale.
It is time to put it on the weighted rating scale. The guys are going to go ahead and put it through its phases.
Yep. And this thing I'd like to mention real quick, a lot of people told us to check this out for the first year and a half that we, you know, when we started the show, and we just didn't have a copy of it. I got it for $15 on eBay, and you can get it pretty cheap. We had it on our store, our Amazon store, and man, this is the best $15 I've ever spent on sim racing. No question about it.
Well, before we get into the weighted rating scale, I'm going to go ahead and give all the viewers out there the specs on this title. Richard Burns Rally, otherwise known as RBR, was published by SCI, developed by Warthog, and released in September of 2004. It simulates both classic and modern rallying and is best known for having one of the most realistic physics engines, even by 2010 standards. RBR was not made to be modifiable, but despite this, there are mods available due to a very strong online community. This game was originally an offline racing game, but users created mods that have enabled online play as well. A sequel to the game is unlikely due to the death of Richard Burns back in 2005. In addition, after the PC release, Warthog was sold to Gizmondo, who went bankrupt in 2006. Since the release, the publisher SCI was purchased by Eidos Interactive.
Before we move on, I'd like to take a quick moment to pay our respects to Richard Burns' family, and just want to say, you know, God rest Richard Burns' soul. And, you know, without him, we may not have one of the best rally sims of all time. So just wanted to take a quick moment and pay tribute to Richard Burns.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate that he was taken away at such a young age. I mean, he did leave a legacy behind. Yeah.
It is sad.
It is unfortunate, but he did leave a legacy behind in the sim racing world as well as the rally racing world.
No question about it.
And hopefully his family is proud about that.
I'm sure they are.
And speaking of this title, Richard Burns Rally, guys put it through the weighted rating scale.
We did. And considering its age, it's definitely holding up well.
Like we mentioned earlier, a lot of mods have came out since its release in 2004, and the guys took the title along with all the mods and put everything through the weighted rating scale.
Yep.
Let's see what they thought.
All right, so here we are for our long-awaited Richard Burns Rally review. It's also going to include RSRBR 2010, like we mentioned. Anyway, obviously, Sean's not with us here. Sean's on vacation, so I got Terry Allen filling in.
Hey, world, how you doing?
So Terry's got a lot of experience with Richard Burns Rally. Him and I and Sean and Andrea and everybody have all spent a lot of time together rallying back last year and now this year with the new mod. And so first up, Terry, dude, Pikes Peak.
Oh, yeah. That's the best part. Yeah, I love it. Always wanted to join the Pikes Peak,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, me too.
And what an experience, man.
Yep, and now it's modeled, or now it's in...
Oh, it's a BTB track.
It's a BTB track, exactly. And for those of you out there that don't know what BTB stands for, that's Bob's Track Builder. and that's a tool that's been around for a while that's used to mod tracks for R Factor, GTR2, Legends, all the ISI
really?
Games.
Yeah, now okay.
Yeah, you know,
I did.
Wow,
no.
Yeah, and now Richard Burns Rally. And I think before we go any further, I'm just gonna run that piece that I put together on the tutorial on Rally Center, which is RSRBR. We've mentioned 2010. I'm gonna tell you guys all, you know, in a nutshell, how to use it and some of the cool stuff that comes along with it.
Let's go.
RSRBR has been in existence since 2005. It was created to consolidate all the enhancements by developers and modders. Cars, tracks, textures, and surfaces are all accessible through Rally Center. Instead of booting up Richard Burns Rally and running plugins from within the sim, RSRBR does it all for you. On top of that, you can organize live competitions that vary from pickup-style rallies to a full-blown championship with service parks. If you're new to RSRBR or Richard Burns Rally in general, there's some additional tweaks to Richard Burns Rally that should be done to enhance your experience. First off, if you're a Vista user that's having problems with force feedback or no force feedback at all, there's a fix for it by editing your registry in Windows. I have it in detail at our forum. If you go to the section titled Sim Software, then look for the thread titled Richard Burns Rally RSRBR FAQ. You can go there to see exactly how to edit your registry. Now for some tweaks to enhance the overhaul gameplay and force feedback. First up, navigate to the directory you installed Richard Burns Rally into. The default is under Program Files, SCI Games, and then Richard Burns Rally. Look for the file named richardburnsrally.ini and open it with Notepad. You now need to delete the first line of text that reads constant force multiplier equals negative 60. While editing the Richard Burns Rally INI file, you can adjust the screen resolution as well. The best resolution attainable with the standard RBR setup is 1280 by 1024. You can change your screen display by editing the lines X-Res and Y-Res. I'm currently running 1920 by 1080. There's also a way to do it through RS Center once you install that. Also located in the Richard Burns Rally default directory is a file called input.ini. If some of your controls are reversed, also open this with Notepad and change the line or lines to say true instead of false. Lastly, delete the pc_inputfilter.ini file that also resides in your RBR directory. The deleting of these lines enhance the force feedback. Next up, Rally Center. Start by going to rallysim.com and downloading all the files needed to take advantage of this great package that the folks have assembled. Click to view their website in English or French in the upper right-hand corner. You don't need to apply the official SCI Games patch to RBR. The files you download from Rally Sim will apply it for you. First, get the main file, RSRBR 2010, and it's about 700 megs. When you click on Downloads, it will take you to their forum. Also, you'll need the second mandatory update that they've released on January 10th. Go back to the main page again and click on Update. Once you've grabbed the two main files, it's time to grab some cars and the extra B2B stages. First, let's get the cars. I recommend grabbing all of them at once, but like I mentioned earlier, you can download them in packs as well. Then it's the B2B stages. After you've grabbed the cars that you want, from their forum section, here's where you have to navigate, grab the B2B stages. Click on Mods, Add-ons, and Updates, then click on Add-ons for RBR and RSRBR. From there, you can grab both packs, 1 and 2, of the B2B stages. Okay, now that you have the main mod, update, cars, and B2B stages, it's time to install the files. The main file will take a while to install, so be patient. Then do the updates, then add the packs. Once you do, you'll have two new icons on your desktop. One that says Lanceur de Add-on, RSRBR, which means Launcher for RSRBR Add-ons, and one that says RS Center. The launcher will open one of many programs. Since we're limited on time, I'm not going to go in depth on every program, but they are all very powerful tools. They include setup, skin, and 3D managers, as well as tools to send replays and stage times. And finally, an icon to launch RS Center. Or you can just launch RS Center from the other desktop icon. Speaking of which, let's fire up Rally Center. This is the first screen you'll come to, and it gives you multiple choices. Starting at the top left, you can log in. My 2009 account worked, but if you're new to RSRBR, you'll need to register. To register, click on this button. You'll need a unique number and user ID. Once you have that, you can race online and or track your stats offline, as well as tailor your profile. If you haven't mapped all your controls or set up your pace note language, video options, etc., make sure you do that before racing online. Boot up Richard Burns Rally in offline mode by clicking on Play Alone or by booting up Richard Burns Rally with Rally Center closed. You need to configure your controls with the new profile that was created called Multi Gatani. This is a cheat profile to unlock everything within RBR. Use this profile while running RS Center. If you want to have an offline career that doesn't have everything unlocked, use a player name that you've created. Once you have, you're ready to race. There's really too many features to mention within RS Center, but what I'm going to do is get you into an online rally. Back from the index page, click Public Sessions. That's when the online version of RS Center will boot up. To find a rally that's currently underway, check the At the Moment window in the upper right corner of RS Center. If you click on the session, it'll give you all the details of that particular rally. You'll be able to join the rally 15 minutes before the start time. Click on Start Online Session to open this dialog box. If your computer clock is not in sync with the server clock, it will ask you to change. If you've selected the right GMT time zone for your region in the settings, you should be okay. I've noticed problems when I've selected -8, so I let RS Center adjust my clock to +1 for rallies. Once here, select the rally you want to join. If there's none, you may have to create your own. But once you do join, there will be a countdown timer to join the first stage. If you miss it, you'll have to go to stage 2. Once the time hits 0, on the countdown, you'll have another 60 seconds to click go to join that particular stage. Once you do, Richard Burns' rally boots up. You cannot restart a stage once you begin. Finish your stage and exit RBR. RS Center then records your time and adds it to the overall rally, and you can see how you did against your fellow competitors. To start your own rally, go to Public Sessions and click this button. You can lock it to one pack or run openly, or you can run it in championship mode where you have to stay with one car. That should be enough to get you going. On top of that, there's so many great tools and features to RS Center that make sure you take the time to get to know how things work. It really breathes a lot of new life into what is already the best rally sim, or maybe even overall simulation of all time. For more detailed information or to discuss Richard Burns or RSRBR 2010, head to our forum at InsideSimRacing.tv, click on Forum, then go to General Discussion -SimRacing Software, and then look for the sticky titled Richard Burns Rally.
All right, so there you go, a tutorial on Rally Center. Hope you guys got a lot out of that. And it can be, man, it's a challenge to get through, to learn that, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty difficult. Yeah, it takes a little bit of time and effort, but I mean, it's well worth it in the long run.
It is.
What
it
a
is,
great game.
It so. Is worth the effort. And again, hopefully that'll help guide you through getting set up and getting out there rallying with us. So. That being said, I want to also mention some other communities out there. I don't know if you're really familiar with these, Terry, but there's an Italian community also. I wanted to mention them, and a Czech community. If you just type in RBR Czech or RBR Italy, there's two different communities that are they're doing some racing or rallying, I should say, and they actually don't use that front end, that rally center. They
really?
Use the plugins within the base
okay.
Richard Burns game. And speaking of which, why don't we go to the base? The base Richard Burns game, you know, which started all this.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty extensive, man. I mean, just, I honestly, I know you haven't had much experience with it, have you? With just the single
not
player?
For a while. No, not much single player.
Just
mainly
the
plan,
multiplayer,
yeah,
right?
Multiplayer mode.
Right. So, and I hadn't either until we went back to review this. And while I did do the rally school, which
I did some schooling.
Yeah, I highly recommend
it's fun.
For any new sim racer that's going to get into serious sim racing, especially if you want to do rallying, do this whole Richard Burns rally school, which
good point you made there.
Yeah, which actually is the same rally school that Richard Burns did when he started, when he was 15. It was
really?
Called the Forest Experience Rally School, yeah.
Wow.
So I guess it's a lot of the same stuff that he learned to rally, yeah.
And it just adds to that sim, because, I mean, what an experience. I mean, to go from that level to the point where you're racing, you know, in a rally season, or even online with your buddies, or people from all over the world.
And there's championships.
You know, event. You
and
know.
At Rally Center that you can do, and the Italian guys. But speaking of, you just mentioned season. The season mode in this is really cool. To get through it, you have to unlock cars and tracks through the rally school, and then you can go join a rich rally season. And in that season, there's actually called service parks. I don't think you've experienced yet the service parks part.
So you repair the cars and stuff in between.
Yeah,
your,
so you got to take
sessions,
care of your car during each stage to get to that service park. And then in the game, you have like a 20-minute timer.
Wow.
A fake 20-minute timer between stages at this service park.
Okay.
And if your damages exceed the 20 minutes, you get penalties.
Wow, well, that adds to the realism.
Oh, it does. And it's really cool.
Interesting,
you can pick to repair different things. Like, I only want to fix my windshield and my brakes and this. Speaking of which, well, we'll get to the damage and stuff later.
Yeah, that's another whole other story there, huh?
So anyway, I wanted to go over that really quick, the single-player mode, and just how cool it is. I mean, just that alone is worth the price of admission. And then you get all, you can get all the mods. And man, this is just...
Yeah, the mods. I mean...
I'm going to say it, and I'm going to say it at the end of this. One of the best Sims of all time.
Yeah, oh, I agree.
So, that being said...
Yeah. Six-year-old, you know, Sim is still just, you know...
It's amazing.
It's just so much fun to, you know, to put in your system and just jump in and play, you know.
Yep.
Hours and hours of enjoyment.
So, that being said, we're going to take a quick break, quick commercial break, and when we come back, we're going to give you my ratings and our closing thoughts.
This segment is sponsored by Sim Raceway.
All right, welcome back for our finale of our Richard Burns Rally Review and RSRBR and Mod Review. And I'm going to put it through our weighted rating scale with our guest reviewer here. Terry Allen's going to also score it along with me. He's actually got
thank
our
you.
Score sheet. No, thank you for joining us here. And first up, physics. Core of the game. And this is what it, you know, where the rubber meets the road, or dirt in this...
Gravel, dirt, snow.
Snow, tarmac. Love them tarmac.
I like the word.
Yeah, tarmac. I say, man, in the dirt for sure, best physics to date. You know what? Now that I'm thinking about this.
I won't disagree with you on that.
You won't disagree?
No, I won't.
No, you won't disagree.
Yeah. Absolutely not. I like the game.
You know, now that I'm thinking about it across the board, I probably would have scored this a 15 in physics. So that's our highest possible. If the physics were a little bit better, maybe on the tarmac. I think the tarmac might be a little too grippy, but still, it's incredible. There's in that, and out of all the cards, there may be that odd card that may not feel perfect, but that may be setup, man. These setup screens and how many things you can adjust, you need like a friggin' engineering degree.
Oh, I agree.
To get through all this stuff.
Yeah, wow, it's amazing. And I was just going to add to that, like you were saying, how some of the cars might have felt, you know, exactly correct. Well, you know, I'm running default setups more or less right now.
Yeah,
and
slight adjustments for me too.
Which are really decent. You know, the gearing seems right and everything. That's for the physics of the game. You know, we had a possible 15 for the score, and, you know, you scored a 14 and a half. I gave it a 14.
So, we were
pretty
in the ballpark,
close, yeah. You know.
14 and a quarter total.
Yeah.
So, why don't we go...
I mean, that's like the benchmark when
it is.
Say. I mean, you know.
It is pretty close to a benchmark setter, no doubt.
Yeah.
Next up, graphics. A little bit dated, but sense of speed is just incredible.
Yeah.
In this sim.
Yeah. And once again, I mean, we're talking about a six-year-old sim.
Yep.
Still, I mean, still, I think it has amazing graphics. You know, the
it
birds
does.
Flying off the surface as you come driving up. I mean, the trees are in, you know, the
animals,
distance.
Photographers.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Rain, snow.
Yeah.
You can go splash
oh,
through
yeah.
water. So a lot of cool, effects.
Yeah. Well, graphically, you had given it an 8, and I actually gave it an 8.5.
So, not bad, 8 and a quarter.
At a possible 10, I mean, that's still a really good score. You
not going to be a benchmark setter, because, like, Dirt 2, you know, we were talking about it earlier. Combine Dirt 2 with this,
you'd
have the ultimate rally sim. I mean, I think we'd get close to 100 in a lot of these areas.
Yeah.
I mean, across the board, I should say. So, next up, let's just move right along here. Sounds. Definitely a strong part of the sim here.
Yeah.
You know, one of my favorite parts of the sounds is when your door is flopping open.
Yeah, buzzing exhaust manifold. You know, clutch slipping.
The steam pouring
out.
Yeah,
the radiator gurgles. You hear the radiator gurgling. I mean,
So great sound effects.
Yeah,
what do we got?
As for sound, good. Giving it a 9. I give it a 9 also.
Both 9.
So, right on.
Almost a benchmark
there,
setter, 9 out of 10.
Yeah.
So almost doesn't get better than that.
Another high score for this one.
Yeah, definitely a great score there. Next up, tracks. Amazing. Especially with the addition of the B2B tracks. They have these super stages. Hill climb is a blast.
Well, not only that, I mean, you can turn some of the, you know, you got the snow, you got rain. I mean, so you take these tracks, you have multiple different. Yeah, nights. There you go. I mean, it's amazing. So, I actually scored a 10, and so did you, and that out of a 10. So, I mean, that was, you know.
Benchmark set.
There's the benchmark right there,
I think we would have scored this pretty high even without all the additional stages because the standard default stages are amazing.
Yeah.
But, you know, add all these B2B stages, and I'm sure there's going to be more over time.
Yeah, obviously.
Incredible.
I mean, there's people building tracks for this all the time now, so.
Yep.
Thank
Next
God
up
for them.
Yeah, thank you guys out there for all your hard work. Yeah, you guys have done an incredible job on those tracks.
Yeah, hats off to you.
Yeah, next up, vehicles. Hundreds to choose from.
Yeah.
From the 90s to current, anything from 100 horsepower up to 600.
Sure, front-wheel drive, rear-wheel drive.
All-wheel drive.
I mean, yeah, you got it all.
Just amazing. You know? Tons of different bodies to choose from, marks, makes, whatever you want to call them.
We've got an old Golf in there, you know, like your old car in there.
Yep, front-wheel drive Golf. Porsche. You're driving a Porsche. I mean, there's just unlimited amount of
cars. Lots of Subarus for all the generations, you know. Yep. All you Subi drivers and stuff.
All you rally lovers, man. Every kind of rally. Peugeot. Yeah. You know, we talked about in our top sim cars, we had Avi's favorite, the old Peugeot.
Oh, so, lots another benchmark. Lots of horsepower, Oh, that's obvious. That's a 10 out of 10.
Yeah, we both gave them 10s. Yeah. You know, and people are going to say 10s. You know, the models may not be perfect, but, man,
it's fun. I mean, come on. Hundreds. You have all these different engines and the sounds.
I mean, just so many to choose from.
I mean, all these cars have a different feel, too. So, I mean, it's very, you know, individual feel of each one. So,
Definitely. Next up, fun factor.
Yeah. Well,
through the roof.
Yeah.
One of the most immersive sims I've ever played.
Yeah.
Amazing that this was developed 6 years ago. And I know. We're still having we ran a...
Still enjoyable.
We ran a rally last night for fun. Yeah. Not because we had to for this piece. Yeah.
Well, you know, I think you're copying me because we both have a 9.5.
I think you're copying. He's copying me. Yeah. We both gave it a 9.5.
A 9.5 out of 10. I mean,
well deserved. Next up, force feedback, crucial part of any sim.
Yes.
10 out of out of a possible 10 points. Mm-hmm. With iRacing, I'd say these two, they're the best in the industry. Rich Burns Rally and iRacing, I'd say the two best force feedback. You can feel the car losing grip, going over bumps, jumps.
When you damage the car, your wheel's cockeyed going down the road. I mean, it's really cool. I mean,
almost too strong. I mean, you can turn the force feedback up or you hit a tree or something. And man, if you have your thumbs hooked on a spoke or something on the wheel, you could probably break a thumb. gave it a 9.5.
Yeah, I gave it a 9.
So 9.25 force feedback, and it definitely deserves it. Yeah. So AI, now we're into the 5-point categories, starting with AI. There really isn't any head-to-head AI, and I honestly was going to give it all multiplayer. We're going to make it a 10-point category and just have it multiplayer, but then I started doing the single-player stuff, and even though they're just spitting out times at you, I gave it a 2.5. I mean, the times are really competitive to race against, and they have the ghost car, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, I actually gave it a 2, and that's simply because of the ghost car, I thought, and you know, I mean, the times seem pretty reasonable when you do race, you know, in the real rally in the season, I mean, like you said, I mean, you're not really racing a real car here, so it's kind of hard to compare it to another sim and say, hey, you know, I'm giving you a fair comparison, which is, you know, I almost think 2 is a little bit too, you know, too much for it, but, you know.
It could be. Yeah, I think I might have been a little generous with it, but I love Richard.
But, you know, hey, this is rally racing, you know. You're not supposed to race against other cars.
Great point.
You know,
and actually,
you do race the clock, so, you know, I'm not really thinking about that at the time of that.
That's a great point, and in Dirt 2, when there's other cars, there's a wreck coming up, it scares the crap out of me.
Yeah, true. I don't think I want to see another car in this, not a Richard Burns.
So I think our overall was 2.25 there.
Okay.
Next up, multiplayer. And supposedly there was a plug-in, we haven't even tried this, where you can run head-to-head. You know,
really?
Multiplayer. I saw it. I don't know how much it. I would imagine it doesn't work all that well since nobody's really using it.
Yeah.
Rally Sim is incredible with Rally Center. How you have the ability to set up rallies with. I mean, we could have hundreds of people joining the same rally.
Oh, it's cool too. You know, you have your flag there. You're representing your country amongst all these other countries. You know, what are they thinking of us? You know.
Many American rally racers out
there.
No,
there's
not.
Guys. That makes me, you know, it's kind of a proud thing.
You got to represent.
Race, you know, and you wonder what these Europeans are thinking.
Represent
Sorry, guys.
Your country.
You know.
Yeah, represent your countries out there.
Definitely. Hey, but more power too. I mean, that's their sport, you know, and they love racing, so.
But not only Rally Sim, we talked about the Italian and Czech communities where you use the plug-in instead of the front-end that Rally Center has. So, what did I give it, a 4 in multiplayer?
Multiplayer, we actually gave it a, let's see, I'm off my scale here. Yeah, so you gave it a 4. I gave it a 3.
So 3.5 is what we gave it a total. Yeah. And I think that's about where it deserves when you got sims like iRacing where you race door-to-door, bumper-to-bumper.
True.
You know? So next up, damage. We're getting close here. Yeah, just amazing damage. You know, all the parts. I mean, actually, we don't even run in full damage. Most people run in reduced. Full damage is just insane.
Yeah. Hood's crunched up. I mean, yeah, and it happens pretty fast, too. So, I mean, it's realistic, you know.
And I noticed different cars.
This isn't Dirt 2. This is a real simulator right here.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, you have to be a little patient when you play this game. You know, you're going to have to take some time and really, you know, put some energy into it.
No
doubt. If you're truly a sim racer, you know, you're going to enjoy this.
Yep. So we got a we gave it a 4.5 with both scored there. And then last two, presentation and cost. Presentation, 2.5 we gave it. You can only use the mouse. Or you can't use the mouse.
No, you can't use the mouse.
Only the keyboard, I meant.
Yeah.
But it's functional.
No intro video or nothing. But you know what? I mean, does that really matter? I mean, is that what I'm here to do? I want to get right into the meat and play the game, you know, play the sim and drive, you know.
And you can adjust all your controls, so that's one of the cool things.
True.
Last but not least, cost. You can get it for under $20.
That's a 5 out of 5. I mean,
yep.
Yeah, there's no doubt because, I mean, for $20, I mean, this is pure entertainment. I mean, and this is a realistic simulator. This is not like something, you know, I'm going to pick up and have an arcade mode where I'm jumping off the track and back on. I mean, this is something that is very enjoyable.
Takes a lot
hours
of time.
Hours and hours of time.
Yep,
and you
no
invest
question.
A lot of time into it to get to that point where you really feel like you're a confident, you know,
bank for the
rally
buck.
Racer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, bank for the buck is just, there's probably not a better one in sim racing right now.
Definitely.
So now our closing thoughts. I'll rank it up there, you know, top sims of all time, if not the.
Yeah. Definitely one of the top. I mean, you know, I mean, I'll definitely say in the top 2 or 3.
Yeah.
You know, which is.
No question.
Know,
and that's amazing.
That's outstanding, you know, to say something about it, you know.
Yeah, and for being out for 6 years.
Yeah.
Overall score, I gave it an 89, was it, I think? Yeah, I had an 89.
Yeah, 89. I actually gave it 86.5.
So
a little bit lower, but still, I mean, an outstanding score, you know.
That gets us right around 87-ish.
Yeah.
And definitely deserves it. And you know what? Would have scored a lot better. I mean, this thing would have been way up in the 90s. Presentation and what was the other one? AI.
But I mean, like you
two
said.
2.5 each. You know? That's 5 points right there. So if we would have added those
and those
five
are two
points,
weak categories as far as I'm concerned. I mean, as for a rally game, it would be. I mean, AI and rally.
Look at the meat.
You know?
All the main categories, the 10 and 15 point categories, it scored up in the upper 80-90%.
Yeah. So. And how many times have you gotten a sim where the intro is like really cool and you actually jump in there and play it and it just does not work well?
But it's cool.
Totally but, down,
but,
so,
but then when you have the combo of a cool intro that gets you pumped up and a
true.
Great sim, I mean, that's always really cool.
Yeah.
So anyway, that's going to do it. Hope you enjoyed our full review here. We went really in depth here on Richard Burns and we hope you enjoyed it. Thanks, Terry, for joining me here.
I enjoyed it. I had a good time.
Yeah,
anytime.
Great having you.
Any rally here. Sim too.
Yeah. Hey, we'll see us out there. You know, look for us out there. We're going to be rallying out there and join us on the forum if you want to talk about it.
Yeah, definitely. Let's see some more people out there. You know,
yeah, no
more,
question.
You know.
Anyway, that's going to do it. Thanks for joining us. Terry, Darren, we'll see you later.
All right.
That's going to wrap up this episode of Inside Sim Racing. Thank you guys for joining us, and we hope that you enjoyed today's show. Make sure to visit our forum, and I have my own section there, the J-Zone, and we also have other sections where you guys can talk with your fellow
sim
members
racers.
Of your sim racing community.
Lots of new sim racers coming in. We got lots of good conversation going on over there, so come on over there and join us.
If you're watching us on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and then you can be notified of all of our shows when they are released.
Yes.
When they do be released.
iTunes too. You can get it on iTunes. You can get us all over the place now, man. We're worldwide.
Worldwide, baby. That's going to wrap it up. Checkered flag is out, and so are we. Promotional consideration provided by Xlerator Wheelstands. Get one now for your 360 wheel at xwstands.com.